Welcome back to Anatomy Dissected by Complete Anatomy. In this video, we will learn about the 12th and final cranial nerve, also known as the hypoglossal nerve. We will look at the function of the hypoglossal nerve, then follow its course, and finally, we will look at some clinical correlates. The hypoglossal nerve, or the 12th cranial nerve, like the accessory nerve, is purely a motor cranial nerve that provides somatic motor innervation to almost all the muscles in the tongue, except the palatoglossus muscle. The hypoglossal nerve emerges from the anterolateral surface of the medulla between the olive and the pyramid. It initially emerges as a series of between 10 and 15 rootlets, and these rootlets pass posterior to the vertebral artery. These rootlets fuse as they enter the hypoglossal canal, a small foramen in the occipital bone. The nerve descends in the neck lateral to the internal and external carotid arteries before passing over the greater cornu of the hyoid bone. From there, it courses anteriorly to supply the intrinsic muscles of the tongue, as well as genioglossus, geniohyoid, styloglossus, hyoglossus, and thyrohyoid muscles, all of which are involved with movement of the tongue. Dysarthria and obstructive sleep apnea are two conditions related to the hypoglossal nerve. Dysarthria is when one has difficulty speaking due to weak or uncontrollable muscles used for speech. This can be caused by nerve damage of the hypoglossal nerve that supplies the motor innervation for most of these muscles. Obstructive sleep apnea is a condition where one starts and stops breathing while sleeping. If there is damage to the hypoglossal nerve, contraction of the upper airway dilator muscles cannot maintain upper airway patency, thus resulting in collapsibility of the airway. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of the hypoglossal nerve, including its course to innervate the muscles of the tongue, as well as the motor function supplied there. Check out Complete Anatomy to learn more.